Your Excellency Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, our distinguished guests, and all protocols observed, and our beloved Juja people, good afternoon. Tusalimianeni. God is good. My name's Mrs. Susan Waititu. I'm the spouse to Honorable Susan Waititu, mother to these wonderful children, and I'm here to present the tribute to my beloved husband, Mheshimiwa Honorable Francis Waititu, and I'll go reading. Let me start my tribute by using my fond name. He is my daddy. That is what I used to call him. As I express my gratitude for having the opportunity to share his dreams, hopes, love, friendship, and much more. My husband was a man of the people, a man who stood by his family throughout, a man who was a hero to all who knew him, a man who loved unconditionally, a man who believed in sharing and caring, a man who put a smile on people's faces, a man who was full of life and humor, a man who was a bigger star in his own right than most of us. You will always be in my heart, and the love I have for you will never die. Your last word to me still echoes in my ears, and I will always remember them until we meet again. To the children and I, we'll always remember and pray for you. The last 3 years have been a true roller coaster of emotions. It has been so hard watching him fight a battle that I knew would always overcome him. The tumor continued to disable his body and cruelly played with his mind, but he kept adjusting to his new normal and fought bravely right up to the end. In December 2017, he was told he had only 6 to 12 months to live, but his sheer strength and willpower allowed him to squeeze in an extra 3 years of living. I'm so proud of you. You never gave up hope, always in high spirit and full of laughter. God gave us a golden chance to bond and recollect. You could always grip my hand, and I felt assured that the fighting spirit was always in you, calmly saying, Mungu ni Mungu. Even when your voice was gone, you could always make me and my sister to dance to your tune, and you could hum, la, 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 la. That's the tune that always remained in his mind. Even when the guest visited, that's the tune he could hum in his seat when he was immobile, and he could dance to the tune, and he could also tell me to stand dance for him and even the guests when they came visiting. I will always be thankful for the wonderful things that he brought into my life together with my children. He taught me how to extend my hand to the vulnerable by embracing them unreservedly. From the humble beginning in our marriage for the last 32 years, he elevated our family to a distinguished status. He was a proper action man, and it was so hard to see this cruel disease stop him from doing all the things he loved. He always enjoyed his job, and nothing could stop him. I remember how I could pack his lunch on Mondays, since he spent the whole day in his office meeting the constituents, but he could end up sharing his meal. Being the firstborn in the family, you carried the mantle in our home. I promised to try my best to see that your legacy continues, and my mom, whom I live with, is well taken care of. I have some reflecting words that I would wish to share. Now I have come to the end's life journey. I've traveled my last weary mile. Just forget, if you can, all the heartache, and simply remember my smile. Forget the unkind words I've spoken. Remember the good that I've done. Forget all the pain and confusion, and remember we had so much fun. Forget that I've doubted and stumbled. The love that we shared helped me through. Remember I've fought tough battles. earning these extra years with you. Then forget to grieve for my leaving. I would not want you sad for a day. In summer, go gather some flowers and remember these words that I say. When you sit in the shade of twilight, then when the sun paints the sky in the west, stand for a few moments beside me and remember only my best. Let's now take a moment and reflect on those words that Mahesh would have meant to us. Sweetheart, into the warmth and love of nature, we lay you down. Into the sadness and smiles of our memories, we lay you down. May you rest in peace, in fulfillment, in love. Into the freedom of wind and sunshine, we let you go. We cherish your memory and let it live on. This is from your loving wife and friend, Susie. God bless you all, and thank you so much.